does that even mean, Bauer's Game Corner?
Ahoy there, YouTube! I'm back again today for another game review. Today I'm very excited to be checking out Gravity Maze from Think Fun. This is for ages 8 to adult. It's for one player and it'll take you a very long time to play. And in Gravity Maze, you will be dropping a marble into a little thing, trying to get it from point A to point B, trying to manipulate the board in front of you to successfully do that. What? Sound intriguing? Let's open up and see how it works.
Alright, then, we're going to take a look at what you're going to get inside of Gravity Maze. Now, first and foremost, we have a handy-dandy rule booklet. It is one very long page by one very long page, double-sided, full color, plenty of illustrations and pictures. Very, very helpful. We'll have you up and running in no time at all. Super simple game, super well-done rule booklet. So, in this game, what you're going to be trying to do is you're going to be trying to get a marble from point A to point B by placing various other different shaped gravity maze pieces on your board, trying to figure out where they go in order to get from point A to point B. That doesn't make much sense to you right now. Let's show you how the game works, show you the components, and you'll understand exactly what is going on. So first and foremost, component-wise, we got a bunch of these cards. We're going to have 60 of these really big cards, which are going to be showing you what you're going to do. So for instance, this one, you're going to be dropping it in yellow, and each time you see the white die, that means that's where you're going to be dropping it, and you're going to be trying to get it all the way to red, which is normally your endpoint. Along the way, you're going to be able to have a purple and a gray that are going to help you, and you're going to be trying to get it from point A to point B. Now, on these cards, also, you'll notice that there's some colors on the bottom. So it's going to start off with beginners, and then it's going to bump you up to intermediate, and then to advanced, and then to wowza, expert, which is where things get particularly tricky. The cards are pretty self-explanatory. I will say, along the way, they will throw you a couple curveballs. For instance, on some of them, you're going to have to put your piece sideways. Now normally you're always going to be using it standing up. However, for this one, you would actually may have to make sure it's sitting down on its side. Also, some of the times you're going to have to be stacking pieces on top of each other. So for instance, this one, you're actually going to stack the gray on top of the green. One more thing to mention about these cards is on the back of every card, they have the answer there. So if you ever get stuck, you can just go back and check that. Also, you can check your work to make sure you did it correctly. So those are going to be the cards you're going to get. Next, you're going to get your nice, sturdy little Gravity Maze holder. Pretty well done. They got a little ball holder right there, which is good because these balls are very slippery and they will just roll all over the place. They got a mind of their own. And then, last but not least, you are going to get these Gravity Maze pieces, which, as you can see, are going to be various different colors. They're going to have various different little things on them. Some will be flat, some will go up, some will go down, some will curve, and you can use them up, down, to the side. There's a lot of different ways to look at them, especially once you start getting to these big ones, and you're like, oh man, which way do I need this to go? So, those are going to be all the components you're going to get in the game. Let's go over real quick how the game is played. So, we will start on the easiest one. We'll start on number one just to show you how it works. So, first, you're going to need to set it up. So, you're going to need yellow and you're going to need red. Now, one thing to pay attention to on this card right here is these black dots. Because we can't just plump the yellow in there all willy-nilly. We're going to have to look for the dots. So for this one, we're going to need 2, 2, and 2 on the left, right, and the top. And looky there, we got 2, 2, and 2. So now we can push that one in there. And as you can see, that thing is stuck in there. Very nicely done the way they did that. Next, you're going to get the red, and this is where you're normally always going to end. And we need 2, 1, 2. So we'd say, oh, there's 2, 1, 2, and we plump that right in there. So we've got our board set up. Now we're going to check down here. Add to grid. We're going to need a purple and we're going to need a gray. So boom, we got a purple and we got a gray. Now I've actually done this before, so I know what I'm doing because I've done the number one one quite a few times with the kids in my class. So next, we have a purple and a gray and we need to figure out how we're going to get the marble to go from here all the way into there. So for this one in particular, it's just a little stair step. And this is one of the first techniques they teach you is that you're going to do that. So let's just start here. Now there's a couple rules you need to pay in mind. First and foremost, you can't have a big drop. So even though this one might work, we can't do that because you can't have it dropping that far and you also can't have it skipping a step. Also, normally, every piece you get, you are going to use. You can't just say, oh, this one's going to go here. We don't need to use it. It needs to be used in some way, shape, or form. Oh, last but not least, I think this is the only other real rule I can think about is there's going to be some flat pieces, like right here. You can't have two flat pieces in a roll. You can't just keep rolling all the way down. So let's plug this one in real quick and see what we got going on here. All right, so no good. So as you can see, it went down and then it went to the side. We need to get over here, so we would both know that, oh, Looky there, we just need to plug this one in like that. And then, boom shakalaka, we have got it in there, and we have successfully completed round number one. Which means we'd be ready to move on to round number two. And as I mentioned, it's going to progressively get more and more difficult. This is definitely not a game where you're going to sit down all in one sitting. You're going to want to work your way up to number 60. But that, in a nutshell, is how Gravity Maze is played.
Alrighty then, Gravity Maze from Think Fun. What are my final thoughts? Let's go over the pros, let's go over the cons. First, on the con side, the game's not going to be for everybody. The obvious reason is it's for one player. So it is a solo game, even though I did play it mostly two-player. We'll get more of that in a little bit. Also, this game straddles that thin line between being a game and being like a puzzle or an activity, which is not going to be for everybody. Last but not least, this is not going to be a game you're going to play over and over and over and over and over again in a short period. What I mean by that is once you finally beat it, you finally get to 60 and you're like, yes, I got through 1 through 60, you're not just going to normally start over and say, all right, now let's get back to number 1. In fact, the next time you play it, you probably will skip like the first 30 of them and just go with the last 30 once they really start to add the meat and get really difficult. So what I'm saying is, this isn't going to be like Ticket to Ride, where when you first got it, you're like, I want to play it. Once you beat it, you're probably going to let it sit on the shelf for a couple months, and then get back to it maybe even a year later. Those are all the cons I have for the game, because Gravity Maze, from Think Fun, look at me, I can't believe I'm saying this, is one of my top 10 games of the year. I can't believe I'm saying that when I got this. It is just so much fun for a lot of different reasons. First and foremost, I want to get into the components. The components are absolutely top-notch. The box is nice, the insert's fantastic, the pieces are great, the board's great, it doesn't feel chintzy, the ball bearings, the cards, everything about this product oozes quality, which is always good, because with an inferior board or inferior pieces, this game could have really got knocked down a couple pegs, and Think Fun knocked it out of the park. But moving on to the actual gameplay itself, why did I like this game? I liked it because it really made you use your brain. And it really is difficult and somewhat frustrating on some of these, where you're just like, I can't figure it out! Which brings me to the two-player aspect. Now, I mentioned that it's a solo game, but I liked it a lot two players. And that's because it plays really well with two players, with children, first and foremost, because you can work together, you can help them out, and they can help you out, and you can, you know, slowly help them advance through the strategies and figuring out what they're going to do. And I liked that an awful lot. I had a lot of fun with it, and I played it with kids as young as 5 in my classroom, and it went over very, very well. Granted, once we got to the yellow, more difficult intermediate cards, that's when the wheels kind of fell off. But for those first 15, let me tell you, that went over absolutely smashing with the younger children. Now, with my wife, and you're saying, wow, with two adults, I don't know how this would play that well. But the thing is, we kind of took turns where I would do the first one, she would do the second one, we'd pass it back and forth. And then when one of us would get really, really frustrated, we'd just kind of shove it over and say, Jesus, stinking game. And then the other person would come in into it with a fresh perspective, a fresh point of view, and they'd be like, oh, this, 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 and this. And it would be like that. I really liked it as a pass-and-play kind of game an awful lot. Now, the ultimate compliment I can give to this game came from my wife. Because me and my wife finished, like, the first 25 in one sitting. We really sat down and vegged on it for, like, a couple hours. And then I came back to it a couple days later, and I was, I was going to do it some solo. And I realized, hey, we're not on 25 anymore. We're on 34. And I talked to my wife about it, and she's like, yeah, you weren't home. So I just kind of got out of the basement and played a little myself. That has never happened before. My wife, first and foremost, has never played a solo board game ever. Next to say, she's never really came down to the basement to get a game to play with her friends ever. So that is a huge compliment, the fact that my wife liked this game so much that she came down to the man cave, the basement, grabbed the game, went upstairs, played it by herself. So as you can see, adults like it, kids really enjoy it. I think it'd be great for seniors, actually, too, just to keep their minds fresh and sharp. Overall, Think Fun, Gravity Maze from Think Fun Games, fantastic, fantastic game. If you have children, highly recommended. If your spouse, your significant other, isn't the biggest gamer, but they like puzzles and mazes, that sort of thing, highly recommended. If you are a senior, I don't think seniors are my biggest demographic, highly recommended. Keep your brain fresh and sharp. Overall, Gravity Maze, the Falling Marble Logic game, 2 huge thumbs up from me. Really enjoyed it an awful lot. So, if you enjoyed this content, please be sure to click on the subscribe button down below. Also, in the comments below, let me know what is your favorite game that straddles that thin line between being a game and being a puzzle or being a maze. whatnot, and so forth. And as always, thanks for your time, YouTube.
That was the review for Gravity Maze. For more reviews and previews, check back at Bowers Game Corner.